Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Digital Learning from Department of Collegiate Education. This is IS Kumar Farzana Banu, Assistant Professor of Botany. In this video lecture, I am going to present BSc First Semester Phycology Anabina Reproduction. Coming to the quick recap of previous class. So, Anabina thallus structure. Anabina is a free floating aquatic freshwater terrestrial alga and some species are endophytic. The plant body is filamentous, unbranched, bounded by mucilaginous sheath. Each trichome is uniseriate with a linear row of vegetative cells, consists of heterocysts and acinetes. The vegetative cells are prokaryotic in nature. Coming to the learning objective and learning outcome. Learning objective is to study the vegetative and asexual reproduction in Anabina, whereas learning outcome to understand the different methods adopted by Anabina. Coming to prerequisites, thallus structure of Anabina, we have to notice the types of cells found in trichome, vegetative heterocysts, and detailed structure of typical prokaryotic cell. Coming to the first slide, reproduction in Anabina, blue-green algae Anabina. So Anabina reproduces by two methods. One is vegetative method, the other one is asexual method. There is no sexual reproduction. Coming to the vegetative reproduction, Anabina is a haploid plant body or plant, reproduces vegetatively by two methods. What are those? One is fragmentation, the other one is harmogonia formation or harmogones. Coming to the first one, that is fragmentation. So during fragmentation, what happens? So here, since this particular alga is a filamentous one, so the filaments are actually break up into small pieces. So each piece or a bit is called a fragment. And each fragment which is carried by water or wind grows into a new thallus, and this particular process is known as fragmentation. This is usually found in the terrestrial species. So in this image, you can notice the filament of Anabina, so which is breaking up. Okay, each fragment, that is a fragmentation taking place. Next slide shows the harmogonia formation. So this is also one of the vegetative type of reproduction, wherein the vegetative part of the trichome or the filament lying between the two adjacent heterocysts is called harmogonium or harmogone. And during favorable condition, so this particular harmogone with the two adjacent heterocysts, so this will develop or break and grows into a new filament. So this particular harmogonia or harmogone can be seen in this particular image, that is named harmogonium. So coming to the next slide. So coming to the asexual reproduction in case of Anabina, that is taking place by three important spore formation. What are those? So one is called acinetes, heterocyst, and endospore. I'm coming to the acinetes. The acinetes, you can notice in the image which is present in the right side. Acinetes, they are the thick-walled, large-sized, non-motile, dormant spores. So these spores are actually present in the trichome here and there. And those spores which are thick-walled and which has lot of reserve food materials, these spores are called acinetes. And as they are non-motile, hence they are also called resting spores or arthrospore. So on return of favorable condition, so these acinetes are usually developed during unfavorable conditions. Okay, and they store reserve food material, but when on return of favorable conditions, the acinetes germinate into new plants. Coming to the next one is heterocyst. So these heterocysts are yellow colored thick walled structures So these can be seen in the image below. Okay, yellow colored, thick walled structures which are found here and there in the filament of anabina. So these heterocysts may be present in the tip. So that is called terminal heterocysts. And if it is present in the in between the filament, I mean in between the cells, they are called intercalary heterocysts. So heterocysts are of they may be terminal or they may be intercalary. And these heterocysts are, I told you, thick walled yellow colored structures or cells which are found in anabina cells, anabina vegetative plant body. The protoplast of heterocysts divides into four cells. The four celled germling comes out by the rupture of heterocyst wall, then grows into a new plant. So that is with respect to heterocysts, and that is seen in the image which is below. Coming to the next one is endospores. Endospores are usually produced inside the heterocyst. So just now we have seen that heterocyst will be there, no? So in the heterocyst, actually these endospores are produced. Here what happens, the protoplast of the heterocyst divides into small rounded structures, and each rounded structure is called endospore. Okay, each rounded structures are named endospores, and these germinate into new filaments on return of favorable conditions. So here, as the plant body of anabina is haploid, hence no sexual reproduction is noticed. Hence there is no alternation of generation can be seen in the life cycle of anabina. So these are the references, and thank you for watching my presentation. Thank you.